We just pulled up to the house of Dot's. I don't know if Dot's here or not, but I see her hairy bush just outside my front windshield here. So let's go see if Dot's home. Everybody, we stopped by the house of Dot's and Dot is home, and I parked right in front of her hairy bush a little earlier today, so I'm out here and stopped in to say hi to Dot. What's going on, Dot?
Well, as you saw a second ago, the bombers are out, those gnarly little beasts that bite people.
There's some big horse flies like that big. And Dot's saying if they land on you, they'll bite.
Oh, they definitely bite. They're really annoying. And they're just silent when they drop down to bite you, right? So, but this is a really popular weapon of choice around here. It needs a little more stringing and such. I'm going to do it with a fishing line when I restring it.
Yeah.
But it slices right through those things. You have to chase them with it, though. They run from it. They don't like it. They know what this does. And then the standard fly swatter. This one's seen better days.
Uh-huh.
I think it is from the 70s. But it works, man. I can usually get them with the fly swatter, but you got to double tap them because they don't usually die on the first round.
Yeah, they're just friggin' huge.
Yeah. Yep. And then I've got a jar of them. I think I've shown you my jar before. Oh. Have I not shown you the jar of?
No, the jar of death.
It's in here. Hold on. Let me see. It might be right in here because I feel like I just saw it.
So it's like your little trophy jar.
Yeah. Yeah. Here it is. All of the bombers that I have killed since I've been here.
Oh my goodness.
Looks 5 years worth of bombers. That's not really very many.
It's like a Vietnamese delicacy.
Yeah, right? They're so gross. And there's some new ones in there. I've already gotten a couple this year.
That's
nasty. This one that's chasing us is going to be in there soon. That's right. It's us or them. This is not a time to be vegan. This is not a time to be all like, it's an animal. No, it's not.
Time to be serious.
That thing came from hell, and that's where it's going back to.
Yeah. And it's this is like a funny time. This is like right on the verge of summertime.
Yeah, we're starting to get some more shade. I got this little room put up here. I don't know if you saw this before.
No.
Yeah, I made it so that I'd have a little shade spot beside the shop, and then I'm going to run one of my triangles like that across here to have a little more shade on this side.
Are you planning on rebuilding the pool area?
Honestly, I don't know. I'm on the fence. I don't even know if I'm going to leave that pool there. I'm going to put another pool in on the other side of the tree over there because it stays, that room over there stays the coolest. And it's just stupid not to put it in there. It's going to fit. I don't have to do nearly as much work. Like to redo all of this, I really have to think about how I want to do it. And I kind of like it open. Like when the pool wasn't in there, it was kind of nice. It made a nice sitting area. So it might go back to that.
It was so much cooler in there because of your layered cloth that you had up
and
there.
And that's what is happening on that side. Because the sun, this is the south side and that's the north side, right? So the sun is like, that's why you point your solar panels this direction, because the most sun is going to be coming from this direction, right? So all of the heat's coming in from this side. So most of the rooms and doors that I do, north side. You do it on the north side so that you get the shade from the building in your space. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then the door's shaded because it's on that side. Right now, all sun's coming in here. I fought the sun all summer. I fought it the first year I had it there. And this year I've decided we're just going to move the damn pool again.
You're so smart, Dot.
Geothermal dynamics.
Yeah, and catotoxoplasmosis.
That's right, man. That's a mouthful. Did you make that up yourself?
No.
Just kidding.
In fact, you got to watch Dot's catotoxoplasmosis. It's fascinating. You know, to take a glimpse into the future, you know, how we're all going to be living in the future, according to Dot.
And I did want to show that we now have a brush garland to tame the hairy bush, in case. So and we added some more hair to the bush for
so
sure.
So you've got more hair on your bush.
Always adding hair to the bush. And I do love it so much when people don't get it right away.
Uh-huh.
That is quite fun. When they're just like, it's a wig butt.
There were many people that said,
a hairy bush. Oh, but I found out what kind of a tree it is. That is the California wolfberry tree. And you can eat the berries on it.
No, California wolfberry tree. Oh, that's fascinating.
I know. I literally 3 days ago, I'm like, oh, there's little berries on that. I wonder what kind of tree that is. And then this dude walked up this morning and goes, do you know you can eat those berries on that tree? I'm like, really? What kind is it? And he goes, California wolfberry. I'm pretty sure that's what he called it.
This is quickly becoming the science channel.
He also said that's one of the biggest ones he's ever seen. So yeah. Not only is my hairy bush special with hair, it's the biggest one he's ever seen.
Nice. Hey, thanks, Dot, for your hospitality again.
Always.
And, you know, it's getting ready for the summertime, so mm-hmm. we'll be checking in on you Excellent. In the middle of the summertime, too, to see Sweet. How you're doing.
You're going to love the new pool setup. It's going to be good.
I'm going to have to jump in there. Jump
That's
in that
right. That would be the only reason to leave that one. Mm-hmm. Public pool.
Yeah, I'm going to be staying out here for a couple of days and a couple of weeks. I'm going to be staying at the Ponderosa, I think.
Oh, all right.
Unless cool. you got a spot over here next to your hairy bush. But
maybe.
Anyway. But no, thanks again, Dot. We appreciate you. Everybody Always loves you on the channel.
Thanks.
And remember, subscribe to the channel if you like what I put out there. Subscribe to the House of Dots channel as well. I'll put a link in the description below and on the screen there for you. So remember, embrace that positivity, get rid of that negativity in your life, because life is too short for anything but joy. And I will see you next time. Thanks, Dot.